Oh my gosh, screens are hideous for your health. And this message is brought to you via your computer screen, lol. Remember how our mums used to tell us that if we watched too much television, we'd get square eyes? And it was only after watching a few episodes of Rugrats and Animaniacs and The Fresh Prince. It's time for Animaniacs. Well, she might have been a bit misled about the square eye thing, but if she'd said, honey bunny, all that TV will damage your frontal lobe structure, cortical thickness, and make you a dumbass, I might have been more inclined to listen. You don't have to scroll too far down your Facebook feed to find urgent pleas from friends seeking new and exciting Netflix binge recommendations. We have our noses in our phones on the subways, in lines, in cafes, in the bathroom. Heaven forbid we not be entertained for just 1 second. A 2016 Neilson Media Report embarrassingly highlighted that Americans spend 10 hours and 39 minutes consuming media each day. And that's not even including all the time that we use our phones for other things like texting and taking selfies. Selfie! That's a lot of time to be focused on a screen, and focusing on a screen near your face for such a long time is actually causing us as the human race to become short-sighted. Previously thought to be genetic, whoops, and putting us at risk of glaucoma, cataracts, and detached retinas. I said retinas. A 2016 study found that by 2050, half the world's population will be short-sighted, which is more than double since the year 2000. The longer you look at something that's near your face, the more difficult it is for your eyes to refocus on something that's further away. And so, if we spend 10 hours and 39 minutes focused on a phone or a TV screen in front of our faces, you get what's gonna happen. Science says, get outside and look at things far away. Or at the very least, follow the 20-20-20 rule whilst you're on your computer. Every 20 minutes, look at something 20 feet away for 20 seconds. It's the least you can do for your favorite sense. Sources are in the description below. Beyond the eyes, brain imaging studies have actually shown that your gray matter, part of the brain, shrinks or atrophies if you use the internet heavily, particularly within the frontal lobe, which is critical for things like planning, prioritizing, organizing, and controlling your impulses. Brain atrophy was also seen in the insula, which we need to develop empathy for others and create meaningful relationships. Damage was also seen in the striatum, a part of the brain which suppresses socially unacceptable behaviors. Awkward. Multiple research investigations have also found that extended screen time can cause a loss of integrity in the brain's white matter, leading to communication failures within the brain, including between the lobes, the left and the right hemisphere, and the paths between cognitive and emotional brain centers. That happens because white matter connects pathways between the brain and the body, and damaged pathways can cause connections to misfire and become erratic. Researchers also found that reduced cortical thickness in teenagers who are addicted to gaming. Having reduced cortical thickness, the outermost layer of the brain, is correlated with impairments in performing cognitive tasks. What I'm trying to say is, being addicted to online gaming can make you dumb. Hey, and I'm just the scientist. I love gaming. Don't shoot the messenger with your virtual semi-automatic rifle. Aside from eyes and brain health, excessive screen time has other really bad health effects. A 2011 study found that prolonged time spent watching TV increases your risk of developing type 2 diabetes and cardiovascular disease. And this is particularly worrying in the US, since we spend over half of our free time watching television. And what's worse, almost all of these risk factors were more dangerous for children when their eyes, brain, and bodies are developing. So if you're a parent, know that the science shows that too much screen time is really dangerous for growing bodies. And whether you employ the square eyes myth or a child-friendly version of the truth, find a way to manage your child's relationship with the screens. And if you're not a parent, you should do it for yourself, because no one wants bad eyesight and a dumb brain. What about you guys? I would really love to know exactly how much screen time you think that you spend looking at a screen. I send a lot of emails and edit videos, so I am reading this off a teleprompter right now. I probably spend an awful lot of hours in front of a screen, so that's probably why my eyesight's not that good. But let us know your screen consumption time in the comments below.
Hi everyone, I'm Jayde Lovell, resident science nerd on the Young Turks Network. You're watching SciQ, and we know you don't want to miss an episode, so please click the subscribe button down below.